हरी ओ अथ हैनम् कौशल्यश्चाश्वलायनः प्रपृच्छ भगवन् कुत एष प्राणो जायते कथमायात्यस्मिन् शरीर आत्मानं वा प्रविभज्य कथं प्रातिष्ठते केनोत्क्रमते कथं बाह्यमविदते कथमध्यात्ममिति तस्मै स होवाचाति प्रश्नान् पृच्छसि ब्रह्मिष्ठोऽसीति तस्मात्तेऽहं ब्रवीमि आत्मन एष प्राणो जायते यथेषा पुरुषे चायै तस्मिन्नेतदाततम् मनो कृते नायात्यस्मिन् शरीरे यथा सम्राडेवाधिकृतान्मे नियुङ्क्ते एतान् ग्रामा नधितिष्ठस्येत्येवमेवैष प्राण इतरान् प्राणान् पृथक् पृथगैव सन्निधत्ते पायूपस्थे पानं चक्षुः श्रोत्रे मुखनासिकाभ्याम् प्राणः स्वयं प्रातिष्ठते मध्ये तु समानः एष हि तद्भुतमन्दं समं नयति तस्मादीताः सप्तार्चिषो भवन्ति हृदि हेष आत्मा अत्रैतदेकशतं नाडीनां तासां शतं शतमेकैकस्यां द्वासप्ततिर्द्वासप्ततिः प्रतिशाखानाडी सहस्राणि भवन्त्यासुव्यानश्चरति अथैकयोर्धपूदानः पुण्येन पुण्यं लोकं नयति पापेन पापमुवाव्यामेव मनुष्यलोकम् आदित्यो ह वै वायः प्राणम् उदयत्ति सहीनं चाक्षुषं प्राणमनुगृह्णानः पृथिव्यां या देवता सैषा पुरुषस्य पानमवस्तव्यां तदा यदाकाशः स समानो वायुर्व्यानः तेजोह भाव उदानस्तस्मादुपशान्ततेजा पुनर्भवमिन्द्रियैर्मनसि सम्पद्यमानैः यच्चित्तस्तेनैष प्राणमायाति प्राणस्तेजसा युक्तः सहात्मना यथां सकल्पितं लोकं नयति य एवं विद्वान् प्राणं वेद न हास्य प्रजा हीयते मृतो भवति तदेष श्लोकः उत्पत्तिमायतिं स्थानं विभुत्वं चैव पञ्चधाम् अध्यात्मं चैव प्राणस्य विज्ञायामृत मश्नुते विज्ञायामृतमश्नुत इति इति तृतीय प्रश्नः। हरिः ओ Kausalya, son of Aswala, questioned him, O Bhagavan, whence is this prana born? How does it come into this body? How does it abide after it has divided itself? How does it go out? How does it support what is without, and how all within the body? He replied, you ask questions about transcendental matters. I will explain to thee, because you are a great inquirer of Brahman. This prana is born of the Atman, as this shadow in man, so is this prana in the Atman. By the action of the mind, this enters into this body. As a king commands his officers, saying to them, reside in and govern these or those villages, so does this prana dispose the other pranas, each for their separate work. This, the apana, dwells in the organs of excretion and generation. The prana itself abides in the eye, ear, mouth and nose. In the middle is samana. It distributes the food supplied equally, and the seven planes proceed from it. This Atman is in the heart. Here there are 101 nerves. Each of them has 100 branches. Again, every one of these has 72,000 sub-branches. In these, the Vyana moves. Again, through one nerve, the Udana, ascending, leads us upwards to the virtuous worlds by good works, to sinful worlds by sin, and to the world of men by virtue and sin combined. The sun verily is the external prana. He rises, favoring the prana in the eye. The goddess of the earth attracts or controls the apana downwards. The akasa, or the ether, between the sun and the earth is samana. The wind is vyana. The external are indeed is udana. Therefore, he whose fire has gone out enters another body with his senses absorbed in the mind. Whatever is thought at the time of death, with that he attains prana, and the prana united with udana, together with the jivatma, leads on to the world through world thought of. The learned man who knows prana thus, his offspring doesn't perish and he becomes immortal. There is the following verse. He who knows the origin, the entry, the seat, the fivefold distribution of prana and its internal state in this body obtains immortality, attains immortality. Knowing the birth of prana from the Parabrahman, the Supreme Self, its coming into the body by the activity of the mind, thoughts and desires, and its staying in the lower apertures, senses, navel, throat and other places, its fivefold sovereignty, the positing as by a king of the pranas to their respective posts, its external manifestation as the sun, ether, wind, fire, etc., its internal manifestation as eye, etc., one attains a relative immortality, the state of Hiranyagarbha or Brahma. Thus ends the third prashna of Prashnopanishad. Hari Om Tat Sat.